an issue that's come up in our gatherings recently, and one that was a springboard to good. It actually launched us into a lot of good discussion recently, was the issue of statements on our tongues, that when we look and evaluate these words, they are statements that are impermissible to make. The likes of when someone sees something that is shocking, impressive, or perhaps annoying or something, he says, "Damn," as an expression. And this is what? From our environment, from the language of the people that we live in. But let us take a moment to look at that word. You know the meaning of the word damn? Is anyone? Huh? La'na. Yeah, it's a la'na. Right? And damn, really, just the phrase damn, it said upon seeing something impressive, and it said sometimes in a time of stress or a time of hardship, that statement has the meaning of la'na, asking for curses. And it's a shortened version of God damn it. Right? Where a person would request, you know, in the English language, they would be intending to request their Lord to curse something. And it's something that the Christians themselves used to, you know, educate their children not to say, these kinds of curses. And it is, in effect, you know, when you're asking for la'na, and of course, it's important to understand here that the one who says it, in accordance to the way people talk in the English language, not thinking about the meaning, then he's excused from these implications. He doesn't intend them, right? He's excused from these implications so long as he hasn't thought about it carefully and he hasn't paid attention to what he's saying. He can be excused from these implications. However, damn has the meaning of mal'oon, or being cursed. And it is what a person says intending to curse something for those who intend its meaning. So it is something that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam forbade us from, that we curse ourselves or that we curse our children. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was not a la'an or a mutafahish. He was not a person of foul speech or cursing and things like this. So we want to watch out for saying these kinds of phrases, as why? They have meanings which are very, very negative meanings that we would not intend if we were to look at their statements. And we have a sunnah in place of that. Perhaps we have neglected an important sunnah, and that is what he has told us to do when we are impressed by something. When we are impressed by something, what? Barriku. Ask Allah for barakah. Oh, Allah bless that thing. If it's the wealth of a Muslim, if it's the son of a Muslim, it's a child of a Muslim, the action of a Muslim, then it's very important, because that tabriq, that action of asking Allah for blessings for that thing, that's what prevents the harmful ayn, that effect from the world of the unseen that is real and takes place on things that are looked at, that are things that are admired, and a person doesn't ask for barakah. Rather, he says, "Wow, look at his car. Oh, or damn," and things like that, right? And damn being the worst of those expressions right there, based on what we've said. All of those can be replaced, or must be replaced, by Allahumma barik, O Allah, or in English, O Allah, bless that thing. O Allah, bless his car. O Allah, bless this. And I raised my children to say this for all the cars in Saudi Arabia that they see that they like. I told them every time they see a car they like, they have to say, "Oh Allah, bless that car." And so when they came back to America, they're going around and they see the cars of the non-Muslims and they're going, "Oh Allah, bless that car. Oh Allah, bless that car." And I'm saying, "Okay, now you can stop."